And now we have the second, but first opening speech, because the previous one was a video by very, but very interesting, because it sets the directions for Globelics. And I would like also to thank him for being the let's say the secretary of Globelics for 14 years, and the founding of Globelics. So now I'm very, very pleased and very, very honored, deeply honored, that I will give the floor to Professor Richard Nelson. As everybody knows in this room and in all over the innovation community, and not only the innovation community, I have to say that he is in one of the most cited scientifically researchers in economics, and he is the founding father of an open evolutionary theory which integrates technological change, institutions and structures in order to understand and to study the long term growth in economies. And also he participated in the whole venture of building the theory of national innovation systems. He was also the editor of a book on national innovation systems, a comparative study. But of course his emblematic work, his landmark work was the book on evolutionary theory and economic change, which he co-authored with Winter, with Sidney Winter, his colleague.
In crime, they say in some way.
Sidney Winter. Professor Nelson is an emeritus professor now in Columbia. He was before in Yale, and he started his career as a research analyst in the RAND institution for 10 years, and then he was perhaps the youngest member of the John Kennedy Economics Advisory Group. So this is another experience that, of course, led him to a more pragmatic approach to economic development and economic growth as a learning process. I was very impressed that when he finished his PhD, because he already has started to study R&D and all the technological works, he went to MIT for some time in order to have also a first-hand knowledge about engineering and science development. So the floor is yours, and I'm very delighted to have you here in this conference.
Thank you.